brought along a guest, Taylor Mingos. Now, this is interesting because, Taylor, groundbreaking, you as an entrepreneur, tell me what it is that you do with Shoebox. Because otherwise, you know, people have these shoeboxes stacked up in the wardrobe.
Right, so everybody that has receipts is familiar with the concept of the shoebox full of receipts. And what we've been doing in the States is allowing small business owners and business travelers to send in all the receipts to us. It's reply paid, so a lot like Netflix in the States you might be familiar with. Stuff everything in an envelope or use our iPhone app, send it in to us, and it's online. And it's exportable into MyOb, into QuickBooks, and all those different software packages here. And we just opened our Australian office. That's what we announced this week at CeBIT, which is our first international expansion. We've seen a lot of interest from Australia, and we're really excited to be here.
But it's not your first Australian customers, is it?
No, actually, the site is designed to only allow signups from the United States and Canada. But actually, some rather savvy Australian users figured out they could sign up with an American address, that there are certain areas on the sites where they could change their address to an Australian one. So we've seen a lot of interest here. And we've also got some press here in the past from like the Sydney Morning Herald, even before we had a service in Australia.
Okay, and you've had a take-up rate, I understand, of around 98.5% of customer retention rate, in the US. So that shows that there is pretty good demand. How are you expecting this sector to grow?
Well, we see a lot of things going paperless. Not entirely paperless, there'll still be paper, but services like us help you take that paper and get the data and the metadata into all these wonderful online apps for running your business, for doing your expense reports, for doing your taxes and your bookkeeping. For example, with Shoebox, you can send all your receipts into us with an integration we have with a company called FreshBooks, basically make your BAS with one click. And that's really the value add here.
Isn't there a concern that you're saying goodbye to all of that hard copy stuff? If anything happens between point A and you at point B, where's your backup?
We haven't had any problems in the States. We actually here and in the States will we talk to the post office, we pick it up directly from them and take out the last leg of the delivery. People can always FedEx or UPS or DHL things in if they want extra security or confirmation. Inside the offices in the States, we have a large processing center in North Carolina. We have physical security, we have background checks, lockers for people to put their stuff. It's very secure. We have third-party audits. It's a lot like a data warehousing service that a larger company would engage.
So is this basically going to take away the need for bookkeepers and accountants for small businesses? Is that the aim?
No, actually our aim is to help bookkeepers and accountants focus on what they do best, which is not scanning and data entering all the receipts. It's actually providing a value add to the clients. We have a lot of bookkeepers in the States that use our product. There's a lot of people in the U.S. that might be using Shoebox without knowing it because their bookkeeper takes all the receipts and then uses us on the back end so that they can take on more clients and service their customers better. We see us as helping bookkeepers and accountants. And
so just to clarify, you're scanning the hard copies into the system. Mm-hmm. What's the next step?
So we have technology we've developed in the U.S. with a great team of algorithm specialists and interns from a lot of research universities in North Carolina. And basically, we use optical character recognition and different software. We have millions and millions and millions of receipts we processed. So a $1,000 receipt from Starbucks, our system knows makes no sense. And that's going to get extra attention. So it goes through our automated processing. And then for things that are faded, because as you know, receipts fade over time. They're very hard to read. There are many different formats. We actually have a human here in Australia for the Australian service, in the U.S. for the U.S., verify anything that can't be read with 100% accuracy. Mm-hmm. And that's the true value add that we have. Our technology lets us do it about a quarter the cost of outsourcing. So it's really good technology. And what's great about that is, when you send your stuff into us, there's a high degree of confidence that if you get audited 4 or 5 years from now, and the ATO wants to see receipts, that everything will be there. You'll be able to search, find it right away. Mm-hmm. The data will go well into other products. And we are ATO accepted.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and you're 25 and you've founded this company, but it's not your first foray into tech, is it?
No, I've always been really interested in entrepreneurship. In high school, I ran my own company, a video production company, actually. That's my first kind of foray into entrepreneurship. I've been programming since third grade. It made sense to go into the web when web apps got popular. Me and one of my colleagues at Shoebox, we actually were some of the first employees at what became the German Facebook. So that company got bought for about $100 million US, and then we moved to this.
Brief final thought, how important has this app been for the real takeoff? People say that this is the road to riches once you get that formulated and out in the market, retire tomorrow.
I'm sorry?
Can you retire off the app?
Can I retire?
Yes.
Not yet, but we're doing very well. Right. We're doing very well.
Well, we wish you even more success moving forward. Welcome to Australia, and thanks for coming on the show.
All right.
Taylor Mingos and Helen, we'll talk with you soon.
Appreciate sure it. Will.